I'm so fascinated by almost all things Amazon, not least of which the business you run, the ad business. Is the ad business that you run principally about driving sales to the Amazon platform, or is there a sort of a brand thing that happens when ads show up on Amazon and consumers are more aware of a brand?
Thanks for having me on, Corey. So it's a combination of both. We work with advertisers all over the world, both to engage with Amazon customers, help them with their shopping experience, make it more relevant, and also work with marketers on branded campaigns and help them connect with customers and drive engagement both on Amazon and off Amazon.
eMarketer has some numbers out that say that the business that you run is doing $750 million to $1 billion in revenue this year. Is that ballpark correct?
I can't comment on the size of our business, but I can comment that we are growing, and especially as we're heading into the holiday season, which we're really looking forward to, we'll continue to grow and connect with customers wherever they are across multiple devices.
So when I saw you present last year at the Ad Age conference, as I've told you a few times, my jaw was on the floor with some of the things that you guys have learned about what works in advertising on the web. You guys have secrets that nobody else seems to get. Share with me one of those, if you will, about what makes an ad more effective on the web.
Well, there are a few things. I remember the last time I was on, we spoke about e-commerce ads, and we continue to innovate e-commerce ads and refine them. Good example of that is we've started to test with dynamic optimization. And what I mean by that is e-commerce ads, it's when you take the shopping feature and functionality, we embed them right in the ads. Shopping features like add to cart, buy now, customer ratings and reviews. And now we're starting to test dynamic optimization where we can watch the performance of the ad and change real time the messaging in the ad, or include things like if there's a buy now button, we can add customer reviews if we're seeing a higher ROI in performance.
That's wild. So it's, you really sort of, when you write the ad, when you sort of create the images for the ad, do you do it with sort of different options available and sub those in to see how they work, like a football coach might put in different players to see what's working in the game?
Well, I know you love your football. I don't know if I'll have a football analogy, but our focus of our advertising program is to make the customer shopping experience more relevant. And one way of doing that is ensuring that the messaging of the ad, the call to action within the ad, whether it's buy now, embedding a coupon, embedding video so that the marketer can both tell a branded story and a call to action right in the ad. So yes, we can increase and improve performance as the campaign is running real time.
It's really interesting. That changes the role of the creator of those ads, the madmen, if you will. I had a job once at American Express where I was designing the gold card application, and they were literally having me create different size boxes for the check marks and focus group testing those different with exact same copy to see which ones would get the most check marks and the most clicks. Are your madmen having to create lots and lots of different options? Is their whole practice of how they create ads changing to allow for that dynamic optimization?
We do create our e-commerce ads in-house. We create them internally. And as I mentioned before, we're constantly testing and learning and evolving and innovating on behalf of our customer. And we're learning things like what the call to action is, the color of the ad, the font size of the ad, the image in the ad, all of that really matters, again, with the goal of improving the customer's overall shopping experience.
Is that secret sauce? I mean, is that stuff that only is done by Amazon employees at Amazon, or are your advertisers like Procter & Gamble, like Random House, like whomever, privy to that new process of creating this new type of dynamic ad?
Well, all of the marketers that we work with, we share standard reporting with them on the performance of the ads. And with marketers who are selling product, it really matters to them the performance of the ad and the ROI that they're seeing to hit their marketing goals.
a lot of in the history of advertising on the web, which now extends for quite a long time here, we've seen CPMs come down. The rate at which advertisers pay to reach users has tended to come down from offline advertising, from TV advertising, magazine advertising. It's a lot less on the web, which you would think that when advertising is measured, the value to the advertiser would be greater, not less. Are you seeing a reversal of that trend in the ads that you're putting on Amazon?
My comment to that is we are growing our ad business. It's a healthy business. Our marketers are very pleased with the partnerships that we've developed together over the years. And again, together, we're just focused on improving the customer experience. But we're seeing healthy growth, and not just in North America, globally.
And globally, is the metric that you report out to advertisers, are you trying to get them to look at something other than the thousands of people you reach, but actually efficacy and clicking through to buy something?
Yeah, so we, again, report out on industry standard reporting, things like impressions and click-through and engagement. And everything that we do in our advertising program is with an eye on scale and scaling globally and creating parity across every country where we exist.
And let me ask you finally, Lisa, do you think that the changes, we were talking about Facebook and Google announcing new platforms today, do you think, where are we in terms of the evolution of technology in advertising? Is there a lot more to go? Is there a lot of change yet to happen? Or are we starting to arrive in some industry standard tools and evolving on top of that?
I can't comment on what a Google or Facebook, what they're doing. What I can comment on is that given the adoption, especially of mobile devices with our customers and the type of e-commerce growth we're seeing on mobile, just last holiday season, 50% of our customers shop via mobile device. That's going to change the way we're thinking about marketing and marketing cross-platform and connecting with customers wherever they are across every digital touch point.